Max is a graphical programming environment where you can join objects together with patch cords to create and manipulate video, sound, data, and more. Max contains many objects that perform functions which are pre-compiled pieces of code. There are many ways to learn Max. The most immediate way is to access the built-in tutorials. These can be found under Max's menu bar, Help, Reference. In the left sidebar under Getting Started, you will discover tutorial sections for Max, MSP, Jitter, Gen, Max for Live, MC, and Node for Max. The Max, MSP, and Gen sections will be most helpful to get you working in Rainbow quickly. There is also an extensive set of examples that can be accessed from Max's menu bar by clicking Help and then Examples. These show the many ways to use Max, MSP, and Gen. The Gen patches can be used directly inside of Rainbow. Let's make a blank patcher. In the menu bar, click File, New Patcher. This is a blank Max patcher. This is where you usually start developing something new. The toolbars seen on all four sides of the patcher window provide valuable resources for programming in Max, getting help and learning more. We'll look at some of the key icons and explain them in detail in a moment. Now let's go to Extras, Rainbow Overview. This opens the Rainbow Launch page, where you can find an overview of Rainbow Learning Resources. Now back in our blank Max Patcher, let's take a look at the icons. In the right toolbar, we have a magnifying glass, which is the search icon. Search in Max is very thorough. It searches the entire Max application, including Rainbow, our website, including forum posts, tutorials, articles, objects, and abstractions. When you're getting to know Max and Rainbow, if you're stuck or want to know more about a function or object, the search sidebar is a great place to start. Below this is the eye icon for the inspector. When you highlight an object in Max, all of the user configurable aspects can be seen in this inspector, and this varies depending on the object. The inspector is the place that you will frequent regularly. You can also learn a lot about how something works by looking in here. Next is the reference icon. This is for finding out key arguments and attributes of an object. If you want to read more about these possible settings, just click on the object and then the reference icon and browse through the details. Next is the Max console. This is where you can print data from your patch for analysis. It's also where any errors that occur will show up, indicated with a red dot on the console icon. The console is really helpful for monitoring, debugging patches, getting information about target exports, and much more. It is a great place to check if your patch is not working as you would expect. There's likely to be a clue in the console. Then we have the audio icon here in the bottom right corner. This needs to be on for your audio signals to work when patching using MSP audio objects and Rainbow. At the bottom left corner is the lock-unlock icon. When the patcher is unlocked, you can make objects, move them around, and patch objects together. To control user interface objects, you will need to lock the patcher. The target icon is the file browser icon. This is an extensive database of everything in Max and in Max's file path. Similar to the search icon, you can find a wealth of information in here. Much like search, we recommend this as a destination to learn more about Max. To get started using Rainbow in Max, you need to have a patch that contains a Max object called Rainbow Tilde. The easiest way to do this is to use a template patch called Rainbow Starter. You can find it by typing Rainbow Starter into the search sidebar. In addition to the rainbow patch, it also creates some surrounding objects that will help you make your first rainbow patch. This concludes our summary of Max and how to use it to start patching in Rainbow as soon as possible. For those who want to continue developing their core Max skills, we will link to several recommended resources below for getting started. And for the next video in the series, please check out Rainbow Basics. Happy patching!